Welcome back children to lesson number 7 fractions. Today in this video we will do remaining questions of exercise 7.4. Now question number 7, find answers to the following. Write and indicate how you solved them. First one is 5 by 9 and 4 by 5. Children, here we will first make the denominator same. That means we will find out a common multiple for 9 and 5, that is 45, or you can find out the LCM also of 9 and 5, that is 45. The LCM of 9 and 5 is 45. Now we will multiply the numerator as well as the denominator with 5 in 5 upon 9, and we get 25 upon 45. And we will multiply the numerator as well as the denominator in 4 upon 5 with 9, and we will get 36 upon 45. Children, here 25 upon 45 and 36 upon 45 are not equivalent fractions. So 5 upon 9 and 4 upon 5 are also not equivalent fractions. Now next one is 9 upon 16 and 5 upon 9. Children, again here also, because the denominators are different, we will find out the LCM of 16 and 9, that is 60 and 9 are denominators. We have to find out the LCM of 16 and 9 to make the denominators common. So children, the LCM of 16 and 9 is 144. Now the common denominators are 144 for both the fractions. So we will multiply 9 and 16 by 9 in fraction 9 upon 16, and we will get 81 upon 144. And in fraction 5 upon 9, we will multiply both the numerator and the denominator with 16, and we will get 80 upon 144. Children, here also 81 upon 144 is not equals to 80 upon 144. That means 9 upon 16 is not equivalent to 5 upon 9. Both these fractions are not equivalent fractions. Next is 4 upon 5 and 16 upon 20. Children, here we will find out the LCM of 5 and 20 to make the denominators same, and the LCM of 5 and 20 is 100. So to make the denominator same, we will multiply the fraction 4 upon 5 by 20. That means numerator 4 will be multiplied by 20 and denominator 5 will be multiplied by 20, and we will get 80 upon 100. And 16 upon 20, fraction 16 upon 20 will be multiplied by 5. 16 multiplied by 5 and 20 multiplied by 5 is 80 upon 100. So 80 upon 100 is equals to 18 upon 100. In both the fractions we got equal numerators. That means the fraction 4 upon 5 and 16 upon 20 is equivalent fraction. Now last one in this question, 1 by 15 and 4 by 13. Children, after finding out the LCM of 15 and 30, we got 30 as the LCM, and now we will make the denominators common or same. So we will multiply 1 upon 15, that is in this numerator and the denominator both will be multiplied by 2, and we will get 2 by 30. And in 4 by 30, we will multiply both the numerator as well as the denominator by 1. 4 by 30, we will get 4 by 30 as the answer. And here children, we have seen that 4 by 30 is equals to 4 by 30. That means 1 by 15 is equivalent to 4 by 30. Now question number 8. Ela read 25 pages of a book containing 100 pages. Lalita read 2/5 of the same book. Who read less? Children, see the first line, that is Ela read 25 pages of the book out of 100. So here the denominator will be 100. And 25 pages are being read, so 25 will be the numerator. So 25 upon 100, fraction of reading pages is 25 upon 100. And when we reduce it to simplest form, we get 1 fourth, that is one fourth part of the book is read by Leela. Now Leela read 2/5 part of the book. Children, total 100 pages are there, and we have to find out how many pages did Lalita read. So we will make the denominator common for both the readers. So 5 multiplied by 20 is equals to 100, and with the same number we will multiply the numerator also. 2 multiplied by 20 is 40. So how many pages are read by Lalita? Yes, 40 pages. But who read less? Leela read less. Leela read only 1/4 of the book, but Lalita read 2/5 of the book. Now next question is question number 9. Rafiq exercised for 3/6 of an hour, while Rohit exercised for 3/4 of an hour. Who exercised for a longer time? Children, this is the simplest one. You can see here that the fractions are 3/6 and 3/4. Rafiq exercised for 3/6 of an hour. That means from 24 hours, he exercised for 3/6. And Rohit exercised for 3/4. Here the numerators are same. So we will see the denominators. Denominators are different. So children, as we have already learned that according to the rule, the fraction with the lesser denominator is always greater fraction. So here 3/4 is greater fraction compared to 3/6. So 3/4 is greater than 3/6. Therefore Rohit exercised for a longer time. Now children, last question of this exercise. In a class A of 25 students, 20 passed in first class. In another class B of 30 students, 24 passed in first class. In which class was greater fraction of students getting first class? Children, in both the sections, that is A and B, children passed with first class. In A, total number of students are 25, and out of which 20 passed with first class. So what is the fraction over here? 20/25. And when we reduce it to lowest form, we get 4/5. And in class B, we have total 30 students, and out of which 24 passed with first class. So what is the fraction? 24/30. And when we reduce it to lowest form, we get 4/5. Children, so in both the classes, the fraction of students passed with first class is 4/5. Hence, each class have same fraction of student getting first class. So children, this was the end of our exercise. Do all these questions in your maths notebook. We will meet in my next video with new concepts.